good morning. The birds are singing, the sun is kind of not shining. Well, it has been hot for the past few days, at least it's kind of a bit miserable today. Anyways, I'm going to do a vlog today. But before I make a vlog, I need to check out something on YouTube. Good old YouTube. What have you been up to today? Wait a minute. They changed YouTube. It's a vlog.
Yeah, I just heard an explosion just across town when I just said thanks internet.
Well, at least I'm alright. But overall, yes, YouTube was kind of at it again. If you may recall a few years back, like YouTube used to got rid of inactive accounts and plus maybe multiple accounts as well. And YouTube's kind of did it again and I'm under 500 subscribers now. But overall, I should get some subscribers back. But a few people have replied to me saying that they have had the same sort of issues and whatnot. And plus someone did reply to me saying he had multiple accounts. And I see the point of multiple accounts. Sure, people do have multiple accounts. But I have multiple accounts for certain reasons, even though that I don't hardly use them. Oh, good old me. Anyways, hi, I'm Stephen Wilkins, DT Films. It's a vlog. So what videos I did this past 1 week? It's funny of which that basically the past few weeks I've been lacking on a few videos. But this past 1 week I had certain reasons. But lucky of which, I made a film sketch video again. Hooray! I'd like to thank all you guys with really good feedback on it. And for those of you that commented, I'd like to thank you guys for that. And the film sketch video was quite good, and despite though I know it was a bit confusing at first, you might have to rewatch it a few times to understand the plot. But other than that though, I'm actually pleased to make another film sketch video for you guys. And also another thing, I was going to plan to do some gameplay of Wii Sports Club, which is the new boxing and baseball update, and I spent the entire whole duration of the day waiting for that blooming update to come out. But it did not came out in the end of it, so I didn't get around to doing a video. The reason why I wanted to do that video, before the retail version comes out next month, which I'm currently saving up at the moment towards it, than it is, which I'll mention about in a minute. But other than that though, I wanted to do a video on that and do some live recording, you know, me playing while I talk about my reasons of why I would like to get the retail version. But yeah, those are the kind of videos I did this past 1 week. The other videos I was going to think about doing, but never thought of doing it. Even though that I'm kind of lacking on Minecraft-related videos, I was going to do some gameplay of the new Minecraft skin pack, which is Skin Pack 6, which came out the following Wednesday. I would do some gameplay of it, but I'm not particularly fussed into skin packs. I would do, you know, mashup packs and plus texture packs, but I just would like to do like them sort of regimes of videos, and plus that when the Xbox One version comes out, I will definitely do a video on that and maybe do some relevant updates for the Xbox One, because I usually do updates for when the updates come out for Minecraft for the Xbox 360, which I do now and again. But yeah, that's Minecraft me in a nutshell. And also, Wii Sports Club video, which never got round to doing it in the end, I downloaded this demo, which is a really good demo, but as soon as I played it, I was like, I regret it now, I should have done some gameplay of this instead, but oh well, what can you do? So those are the kind of videos I did this past 1 week. On the last vlog, I mentioned about getting a particular DLC for really, really cheap for 79p, which was in the Saberwolf DLC for Killer Instinct, and I recently got that, and I've been like getting some extra achievements and whatnot. And since I've been not concentrating on my game score on Xbox Live as much, and basically I was nearly enough to my next K, and then I started playing the Saberwolf DLC, and I've been like squeezing out so much, gamer score out of that, and I recently, and this past 1 week, finally got to my next K, which I got to 68k gamer score, which I'm really, really pleased of. I'd like to thank that Saberwolf DLC for squeezing, you know, that many GameScore out of it. While we're on the subject on Xbox related things, I want to mention about Games for Gold that's happening for next month. And even though the Xbox One is slightly a bit off-putting, but they're doing something great, which I'll mention about in a minute. But basically, even though that they're redoing a Max and the Brotherhood type game that they did this month, and they're doing it again this next month, I'm like, why would you do that, Microsoft? But then again, good reason to. Because basically, next month, not only it's Games for Gold for a particular game next month, but basically they're doing it for a new release game, which is really, really good, even though that PlayStation Plus has done this for indie-type games. But it's nice, however, that Xbox One has that sort of regime. And basically, Guacamelee, if you may recall, this indie-type game that's coming out on multiple platforms next week, and basically for those people that are Games for Gold members and Gold members, you can get that game for free on Xbox One, which is really, really good. I'm really looking forward to getting that game for free and have a little play with it, and also do some gameplay for you guys once that comes out. Gonna be a really busy Wednesday. But other than that, though, on the Xbox 360 side, even though that already got to Gotham City Imposters, but I'm really looking forward to Battle Block Theater, whatever it's called, the people that made Castle Crashers and whatnot. I'm looking forward to getting that because I haven't got that game. But I recommend you guys getting Gotham City Imposters next when that comes out next week for next month as well. Before I start mentioning about this, I just want to quickly tell you in advance that they have fixed this issue, but I wanted to explain my thoughts and plus my experience with this issue as well as this issue technique in advance. And basically, this past following week, I actually got the July preview for my Xbox One, since I'm part of the preview program, and I didn't know if I'm still allowed to mention about this. But anyways, and there have been some technical issues, and Xbox have been sending out messages saying there has been a black screen issue. And I'm one of the unlucky people that kind of got the black screen issue. And I was a bit Xbox One less and basically was having a bit of withdrawal symptoms, since I'm used to doing stuff on my Xbox One than my Xbox 360. Sorry to say, you may have followed up on my baseball and my Twitter feeds, which you should do. But overall, I kind of found out a way to bypass the black screen, and this is great for anything in advance. And even though I have tried the hold the power button for 10 seconds, plus unplugging the device and holding the button for 30 seconds as well. And that didn't even work on my Xbox One. So when I had the black screen issue, basically I tried this particular app which I use to send videos onto from my iPod, which is this Flips type app, which I kind of use, which is for free on SD, and you have to pay for the HD version, but luckily I got the HD version for free, knowing me. But other than that, I actually sent a particular video, onto my Xbox One, and for some reason it launched Xbox Video and got rid of the black screen. And then sure enough, the Kinect and plus the Xbox One interface was not particularly disabled and was not particularly working. So basically, I can actually send stuff from my Xbox Smart Glass and launch games and apps, which is really, really good. But still, however, the Kinect and plus interface was disabled. Now, another thing that happened, because I still have the Thief demo that I installed on my Xbox One, and I mentioned on the last vlog that I kind of had a technical issue where it basically needed an update, and basically there was an error with the update. Well, as soon as I got the update error, it somehow broke boundaries on the Xbox One and got back the interface plus the Kinect features, and basically I got the Xbox One back. Even though it's a few minor steps, it's great though that basically I got off Xbox One working until they kind of fixed it with a patch. Whew, that's a lot to say. But overall, since I've been having that issue, I just found out this solution, and basically it just kind of worked. Even if I still had this black screen issue, I was not too worried about my Xbox One, since basically there's not particularly much games next month for the Xbox One that I would like to get. Even though that they did announce that Guacamelee will be for free for Gold members, and that will be, when it's released, it'll be for free for Gold members. So I'm lucky that my Xbox One is actually fixed during that time. But other than that though, I was not too worried about it for next month, since I mentioned about this on my Tumblr post, that basically there's not much that I would like to get next month besides Wii Sports Club. Because basically, the reason why I would like to get Wii Sports Club, I do enjoy the Wii Sports game on the Wii back in the good old days. I would like to get that on the Wii U with the whole HD remastered type whatever. And basically, I would like to get that because basically, it costs like £50 for digital download, knowing digital download type things. And basically, I haven't got that much memory on Wii U. It's just nice, however, that they're doing the retail version for particular, maybe for particular people like myself who had the basic versions of them Wii U's. But yeah, I'm looking forward to getting that as soon as that comes out. But other than that, though, there's not much games I would like to get. So I'm trying my very best to get some particular Blu-rays that are coming out next month, which I will do videos of. I mentioned about this on a Tumblr post as well. And basically that the Ashen's Quest for the Game Child will come out on Blu-ray. There's just hopefully my HMV does stock it, let alone ordering it on Amazon. But other than that, though, I'm really looking forward to getting that in Blu-ray since I enjoyed the YouTube movie when it was first out on YouTube. I would like to get that on Blu-ray. Plus, the Lego movie comes out next month on Blu-ray and DVD. I would love to get that on Blu-ray. But other than that, though, those are what I would like to get. But I have mentioned on a Tumblr post also that I recently got my job pay and I got a big sum because I got my holiday pay early. And I'm saving most of it towards whatever games are coming out for the rest of the year, which I got enough for at least two Xbox One games, which is a really, really good start. And I'm putting whatever money's towards getting the two Blu-rays I want to get next month. But other than that, though, even though knowing me, getting some pickups and whatnot, basically I did kind of get a pickup from my local cash converters again. And basically I got Little Big Planet for the PS Vita because I haven't got much games for my PS Vita lately, knowing me. But other than that, I'm actually pleased to get this for £7 since other places do it for like £10 to £15. And I gotta say, it's really, really good comparing to its bigger brother on the PS3 for Little Big Planet 2. But other than that, though, I would like to get Little Big Planet 3 when it comes out on PS3, since they did announce that it's going to be out on PS3 as well as PS4. And plus, another funny thing is, though, that basically as soon as I got this, this was on sale on PlayStation Network, but then again, I haven't got that much memory on my PS Vita, so it's nice to have the retail copy anyways. The downside is, though, it didn't have the online pass, so I can't use the online features, but at least I can just play some levels, create some things. I actually watched Google I.O. this past 1 week since I have have multiple devices, and I recently got myself a Nexus 7 last year, and I'm starting to get used to Android. And Google I.O. did a really good keynote, since basically I'm looking forward to the new operating system for my Android device, as well as they're implementing their operating system onto multiple devices, like say for example their Android Wear, even though that would like a smartwatch, but I'm particularly interested in the Pebble since basically I do have multiple devices, let alone my Windows phone is my phone type thing. But other than that, though, I would like to maybe perhaps get a smartwatch, but who knows. And I like the idea that they're actually doing Chromecast, so basically you can stream mirroring your Android device. I doubt that will work though, because basically I would like to get Chromecast mainly for that, but I tried this on my iOS device, but it did not work on my Roxio due to signal protection. Thanks, Roxio. But other than that, though, I might get it and try it out, but we'll have to see. I like the idea because, as you may know, I usually spend my phone credit mostly on Xbox Music. And I like the idea that they're implementing a mobile payment onto Nexus devices, even Wi-Fi models such as mine, which is quite nifty, so I could buy Google Play stuff with my phone credit, which is quite good. But other than that, though, I've been fine and dandy. You may have heard I've been having my sister over a bit more because she's a cheeky little monkey because she wants to see her big brother, which is quite nice since I'm usually on my own. But other than that, what videos I'll be doing next week? Queer Law Soft will be coming over, which I mentioned in the last video but didn't say a bit properly. It's this week, actually, not last week. But he'll be coming around, and I do not know we'll be doing a video. Plus, I'll be doing a video of Quackamelee when it comes out next week. But other than that, then, yeah. So that's my vlog for you guys. Hope you've been updated. Do not forget to follow me on Facebook and Twitter. I know you guys have a nice weekend. I'll be having Queer Law Soft over for the weekend. Anyways, I better go now. See you from CT Films.